This is part 31 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to deploy ASP.NET Core Web API along with a SQL Server database to Azure App Service right from within Visual Studio. Deploying a web API is very similar to deploying a web application. Let's take a look at the steps. In Visual Studio, in the Solution Explorer, right-click on your web API project and then select this option, Publish. We want to publish to Azure, so select Azure as the target, click Next. On the screen, select Azure App Service and then click Next. At the moment, in Azure, we don't have any App Service instances, and that's the reason we don't see anything within this App Service instances box. Now, we want to create a new instance of App Service to which we want to deploy this web API. And for that, click on this plus sign right here. Provide a meaningful name for the app service instance. I'm going to name it Employee Management API, and then select your subscription from this drop-down list, and then a resource group. I'm actually going to create a new resource group. Let me name it RG API for resource group API. We want to start free in Azure. So let's create a new hosting plan. Provide a name for the plan. Select the region where you want this plan to be created. I'm actually going to select East US, and then the size for your plan. We want to start free, so let's select that. And in the future, if we want to add more features, we can always scale this plan up. So let's click OK, and then create. At the moment, an app service instance is being created in Azure. It's going to take a few seconds. There we go. We have our app service instance created. And notice, by default, this new instance is already selected, meaning we are going to deploy our API to this app service instance. So let's click Next. On this screen, it's asking us if we want to create an instance of API management. We'll discuss what is Azure API management and the benefits it provides in our upcoming videos. For now, let's skip this step by selecting this checkbox and then click Finish. At this point, we have a new instance of App Service created in Azure, and we have configured Visual Studio to deploy to that App Service instance. And remember, for our API, the data comes from a SQL Server database. So our web API has a dependency on a SQL Server database, and Visual Studio is smart enough to detect that dependency. Notice, under Service Dependencies, Visual Studio is showing there is a dependency on a SQL Server database, and it's asking us if we want to configure it. So our next step is to create a SQL database in Azure. For that, click Configure, and then select Azure SQL Database, click Next. At the moment, in Azure, we don't have any SQL Server instance. First, we need to create a SQL Server instance before we can create a SQL database. So for that, click on this new link next to Database Server. Provide a name for the database server. We have a validation error at the moment, and that is because we have a dot in the server name here. Not sure why it included it in the first place. And then a location, administrator username, password, confirm password, and then click OK. And then create. At the moment, both SQL Server instance and the database are being created in Azure. There we go. Both the server and the database are created. Let's click Next. On this screen, provide the database connection username and the password, and then click Next and finish. Finally, close. Now, so far, we have done two things, created a new instance of App Service and a SQL database in Azure. Before we can deploy this API in Azure, we need to do one more little thing. Remember, the data for our API comes from a SQL database, and we want to tell Visual Studio to execute these database migrations when we deploy this API in Azure. And to do that, click on this edit link here. On this Publish dialog, click on this Settings tab, and then expand this section, Entity Framework Migrations, and check this checkbox here. Apply this migration on Publish, and then click Save. We are almost there. All that is left right now to do is click this Publish button. There we go. Our API deployment is in progress. It's going to take a few seconds to complete. There we go. Our API deployment is complete. And at the moment, we see a 404 error. And that kind of makes sense because at this root URL, we don't have anything to display. Now, if we want to see the list of employees, then navigate to this endpoint /API/employees, and we see the list of all employees. If we want a specific employee, simply pass the ID. And similarly, if we want the list of all departments, API/departments. In our previous two videos in the series, we discussed what is Swagger and how to use it in a .NET Core project. So if we navigate to this endpoint, we should see the OpenAPI specification document for our employee management API. There we go. We see the OpenAPI specification document. And remember, it is this OpenAPI specification document that drives the documentation of our API. And to see the documentation, we just navigate to our root application URL /swagger. There we go. We see our API documentation as expected. Now, here's what we want to do. When we navigate to our root application URL, at the moment, we see a 404 error. Instead, we want our API documentation to be available at this root URL. And for that, we need to do a small change in startup.cs file of our API project. Basically, we are telling with this change, we don't want to use any route prefix. Now let's deploy our changes to Azure. There we go. At the root, we now have our API documentation, which makes more sense than displaying a 404 error. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.